Hey everybody, Mo Cheeks here. Today I want to speak directly to the students in our community. During this week of civil unrest, I've been wrestling with all too familiar emotions that have been flooding back since learning about the murder of George Floyd. And it frankly pains me to know that as students, so many of you are dealing with and grappling with similar emotions, particularly students of color, particularly Black students. I know that you're hurting. I want to tell you it's okay to feel pain, it's okay to feel grief, it's okay to be sad and angry and tired. We're all tired. That's super real. But I want you to know that your lives matter, that you are loved, and that your future is going to be bright. That's real, too. Some people know me from my years of service as an elected official here in Madison, but before any of that, more than any of that, I'm a husband, I'm a father of two little kids, I'm a son, and I'm a big brother. Speaking of my two younger brothers, both of them, on separate occasions, have had the horrific experience of being stopped by police while unarmed and had police officers put a gun to their head. There are no words for how helpless I feel when I think about how I could have lost either one of them on those occasions. I never really tell people about that. And just that reality reminds me how growing up Black in America, there are so many ways in which we find ourselves carrying grief that goes unsaid. Many students of color understand that firsthand, of course, that grief that comes with racism. But I have to tell you that our community response to this moment feels different. There seems to be a willingness to understand and acknowledge the pain of systemic racism like nothing I've seen before, and it gives me hope. And I hope that it gives you hope. Students, I wanna encourage you to keep striving for justice. Your voice is having an impact, for sure. Not only are you going to change the world, but you are already successfully changing the world. Public data shows that public opinion is shifting, and that's because of you. It's because of your efforts. For 400 years, this country has largely turned a blind eye to the cries that Black Lives Matter, but the protests that are happening now, and frankly, the conversations that students are having with each other, with your families, with your teachers, with your loved ones, are all resulting in you bending society towards justice faster than anything I've ever seen. So I just want to encourage you to keep organizing, keep learning, keep being reflective, keep the faith, keep finding constructive ways to mobilize yourselves as you work to mold society into one that's worthy of the next generation, a society that you want to grow up in. I also want you to know that whatever school looks like next year in light of the coronavirus, that the Foundation for Madison Public Schools will continue to be here to uplift our public schools and our students and our community. Just this week, we're excited to be supporting the Black Girl Magic Conference. And we're going to keep working to be a voice for progress for our community and within our schools. While I was running for office, I often talked about how I got my start in public service in our community by volunteering as a tutor in our schools. I tutored at Memorial High School when I was maybe 26 years old. Today, as chair of the Foundation for Madison Public Schools advocacy work, I promise you that we will continue to fight for a city full of students with big dreams and teachers with big hopes for their students, and school buildings that are not only beautiful places to learn, but are safe spaces where we will equip the next generation to lead us. So we're in this together. Stay safe. I love you all.